I thought it was irritating when all walls are modeled in Revit and we need to change them or split them by level. So I tried to improve that and made a smaller bottom to split many walls by level in Revit. So let's jump into Revit. Great, so I'm going to split the walls in this this building, in this 3D model. So I'm going to go to split by levels. This is actually more than an update than a new bottom. This used to be called split columns, so it does also work with columns. But in this case, I'm going to select two walls, the levels I want to use for the cut, and then I have the gap option. For this, I'm going to set this to 50 and 50, and this is basically the gap from every cut. So this means that it's going to be 100 millimeters gap in every cut, and then it's going to be 50 up and 50 down. Then we have an option for profile edited walls. I'm not going to check this, but it does also work with those. So probably when you have like a lot of like rectangular walls like this one that are simple and straightforward, you don't need to select those. But if you have like more complex with some different shape or edited profile, you can just check this. I do recommend to when you have like super complex profile edited walls, like with a lot of holes and things like that, I do recommend to use the default tool, which is should be around here. Yeah, split element and split element with gap. So these are a little bit more limited, so you don't have that flexibility with the distances. But still, when you have like super complex profile edited walls, it may make sense. So yeah, for my case, when we have like a lot of cuts to make, it's probably faster to use this. So I'm just gonna run it, and then we see that all the cuts are made. Also, the windows are placed there. If there is like, I think these are like wall sweeps. Let me check that real quick. Yeah, wall sweeps also follow the shape of the wall. And yeah, we see, for example, these windows, I think because they are hosting one of the walls and not the other, it does have this preview. So if the walls are between levels, that's something as well to consider. Probably I think my favorite part is that you can play with these distances. So if I set this to 0 and 0, the cuts are going to be made only on the levels, and the walls are going to be one on top of the other with no gap. But if I set this to minus 50 and 50, I can actually displace the cut a little bit up or down playing with this minus sign. So for example, in this case, I can see that the cut is a little bit lower than the level, but the walls are still together. There's some limitation still, for example, the thing with the windows we saw before. But also, if the walls are next to the end, to the corner, those ends may need to be done or do something like this, just to be where it used to be. So that's something that should be made as well. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this small tool, and thanks for watching. Bye bye. Have a good day.